1, chapter 5 of Sons and Lovers is called Paul Launches into Life. Paul is 14 and has just finished his schooling. Mr. Morale is injured at work. After a week in critical condition, he starts to heal. Paul joyfully becomes the man in the house now. Paul's main interests are reading and painting, and working to eventually have a cottage with his mother. At his mother's urging, he answers ads in the local newspaper for jobs. In contrast to Paul's quiet and sensitive nature, William has become a swanky gentleman in London. He's met a tall and elegant young lady at a dance, Lily, but William calls her Gypsy. He sends his mother a picture of her. Lily is bare-shouldered, and Mrs. Morell is offended by her pose. William apologizes and sends a second photograph in which Lily is dressed in a black satin and lace evening dress, but this also offends his mother. Paul receives a response to one of his letters, and he and his mother travel together to meet Thomas Jordan, the owner of a surgical supply business in Nottingham. Paul and his mother sit opposite each other on the train, and when their eyes meet, his mother smiled to him, a rare, intimate smile, beautiful with brightness and love. As they walk to the interview, they both feel the excitement of lovers having an adventure together. Mr. Jordan hires Paul as a junior spiral clerk. He will be copying letters and writing orders. He's to report to Mr. Pampleworth. Paul slowly copies letters into a book, and writing orders for the girls in the factory, Paul adapts to his new job, makes friends, and appreciates his boss's friendliness. Plus, all of the girls take a liking to Paul. Paul's Oedipal feelings for his mother continue to manifest themselves in this dream of sharing a cottage with her someday. Mrs. Morell prepares to rush to the hospital by hurriedly taking off her bodice in front of Paul, and her son admires her handsome, strong arms. Passion has overcome both sons, but in different ways. While Paul dreams of his mother, William has broken through these maternal bonds and fallen in love with Lily. Stockings become a symbol in the story, first representing the factory where Paul goes to work, and then the servitude of women working there. Stockings signify women and women's roles, and the symbolism extends to the women creating the stockings.